हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, हम पढ़ रहे थे न्यूक्लियर पावर प्लांट। लेट्स स्टडी हाउ अ न्यूक्लियर पावर प्लांट वर्क। हाउ कैन इलेक्ट्रिसिटी बी जनरेटेड विद द इन अ न्यूक्लियर पावर प्लांट। लेट्स सी, इन एज वी हैव स्टडीड दैट इन अ व्हेन वी बर्न एन न्यूक्लियस ऑफ यूरेनियम, इट रिलीजेस अ लार्ज अमाउंट ऑफ एनर्जी। दिस एनर्जी इज यूटिलाइज्ड इन प्रोड्यूसिंग स्टीम, in producing steam, and the steam runs the turbine or it rotates the turbine and thus produces the electricity as we were discussing from the starting in this chapter that the main motive is the rotation of the armature. How you will rotate the armature. As in thermal power plant we had used the steam, in the same way here also we had used steam to rotate the turbine. Now the thing is how we have generated the steam. Over here we had utilized the energy released during a nuclear fission reaction to form steam, and thus this steam rotates the turbine, and through the turbine electricity is produced. This was the nuclear fission reaction. In India, we had a number of nuclear power plants. One of them is located in the Rajasthan also, the Rawalpindi plant, the nuclear power plant, and in many places in India, we had nuclear power plants. Nuclear power plants were earlier used for in a destructive way. After that, their constructive way in the production of electricity was regained, and it was started producing electricity with the help of nuclear power plants. Okay, there are certain hazards also of the nuclear power plant. The products which formed are radioactive elements. It causes many diseases in the human beings, or the leakage of nuclear fallouts is also very dangerous. So there were many hazards also of nuclear power plant. Let's now study about the different reaction, which is nuclear fusion reaction. Earlier we had studied about the nuclear fission. Now it is nuclear fusion reaction. Fission means breakdown, and fusion means what? To form. So nuclear fusion reaction, in this smaller nuclei combines to form a bigger nuclei, and it releases a large amount of energy. This reaction is known as what? Nuclear fusion reaction. Okay. Now, example of nuclear fusion reaction. This is deuterium 1H2. When two deuterium mixed or combines, they form 2He3+1 neutron and a lot of energy. So this is the example of nuclear fusion reaction. Now we will be discussing about the differences between nuclear fission and fusion reaction. Let's see what are the differences between nuclear fusion and fission reaction. Okay, these differences can be asked in your examinations. Nuclear fission, and other one is nuclear fusion. So first point would be the definition. According to the definition, the nuclear fission reaction is the reaction in which a bigger nuclei splits into the smaller one. In this, a bigger nuclei splits into smaller nuclei. And what happens over here? Here, smaller nuclei combines to form a bigger nucleus. Combines to form a bigger nucleus. Okay, this was the first point. Now coming to the second point. In nuclear fission reaction, nuclear fission reaction can occur at all temperature. Can occur at all temperature. But for a nuclear fusion reaction, it requires a higher temperature. It requires a higher temperature. In this reaction, nuclear fission reaction, a minimum amount of fuel is required. Minimum amount of fuel is required. And in nuclear fusion reaction, there is no such requirement. No minimum amount of fuel is required. In a nuclear fission reaction, the particles, the products which are formed are mainly radioactive. The products formed are mainly radioactive. But in case of nuclear fusion reaction, these are not so. The products are not radioactive. So these are the four differences between nuclear fission and fusion reaction. By this topic, we had come to an end of the chapter Sources of Energy. I hope you all have done very well in this chapter. I had revised each and every topic again and again. After that, we are starting with our chapter Electricity. Thank you, students.